Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Weisenheimers.
First and foremost, we say this at every show. How many of you, this is your first Weisenheimer show?
Wow.
You picked a winner. Wow.
God bless you.
Just so you know, they're usually much cheaper than this. Yeah. They're literally half the price. You chose like the most expensive one. So we wanted to cover some ground. We got some calls before we did the show. And some folks asked about like the appropriateness of content.
Right.
Yep. So I feel that a lot of how should we dress tonight.
Right.
And I'm really glad none of you are wearing bikinis and tank tops. pretty common.
I don't see a tube top either. So
no,
that's good.
Not like a regular show at all.
Nope.
So we want to let you know that we're gonna be on our best behavior because it's such a classy venue.
Okay.
Best. Regardless, we're going to do our best to just to give you an idea of some things we're going to avoid. We're going to try and stay away from the F word.
Right.
F word is out, probably. Mostly. Most likely.
Most likely, you'll probably not hear the F word unless we really mess up.
I mean, or it works in context.
We'll see how it goes.
Right.
Asterix.
Yeah. You definitely will not hear the C word.
The
bad C word.
Yeah, they're real.
Really bad.
You'll hear other C words.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah.
Crap.
Yeah. Crap. Yes. Is one. Yeah. Cello.
Cellophane. Communism.
Communism. You will hear communism. We'll probably factor into it tonight.
Yeah. We got the whole second half. It's all about
yeah. You'll probably hear at least two words beginning with X.
Sure. Yes. At least two.
At least two.
Mostly X hyphenated.
X hyphen,
most likely.
Yeah.
Not a lot of words.
Yeah.
There'll be some accent aigus.
Yep.
Accent grave.
Maybe an umlaut.
Definitely an umlaut. People from Norway are funny.
Jerry's still out on the little N with the thing above it.
No ideas.
Mostly because I don't know what that little thing's called. Somebody said tilde.
Tilda.
Tilda.
Okay.
She's great. I love hearing that one.
I thought I heard something else. That was our first suggestion. I'd be like, we hear that all the time too.
Yeah.
Oh, we should talk about suggestions.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Too. Right. So this is our 20th anniversary. We've been doing this for 20 years. And some of us have been doing it a little bit longer than even the Weisenheimers were around. So we're going to ask you guys for suggestions, all you who chose this to be your first show. Let me explain how this works. So we'll ask suggestions, and you can give suggestions like Tourette's. Or gynecology or proctology or gay bar.
Dildo.
You could give those suggestions. We will ignore those suggestions because we've been doing this for 20 goddamn years, and we have heard that every goddamn show for 20 goddamn years, and I'm just not going to do it anymore.
The GD
word you're going to hear about four times.
Yes. We probably should have slid that in there.
Yeah, that was...
We apologize.
Matt was supposed to warn them.
Yeah,
sorry about that.
Yeah, so Matt dropped that line.
So,
that's how it works. We should start with the first game. Who'd like to see an
improv show?
Yeah.
Yes, if you're thirsty, the bar will remain open. You can still get up and go back there. We will not make fun of you for that.
Yeah.
The bar is going to remain open until the end of intermission. Surprise, there's an intermission.
Sure.
Or to clarify, we will be making fun of some of you.
Yeah, it will really kind of depend on what you're wearing and how funny you walk.
But not the drinking ones.
Okay.
But we're going to do our first game. And for this first game, I need a place that somebody works.
Toilet.
What was that?
Triple A. They work at Triple A. That's awesome.
Specific.
Yes. So we're going to start this off with, was it Matt and Teresa?
Yes.
Yep, Matt and Teresa. This is a game called The Question Game. And in this game, Matt and Teresa are going to be acting on a scene in a Triple A. They will only be able to ask questions. When they are unable to ask a question, then one of us will have to swap in and ask a question for them, and then we'll continue on with those characters, okay?
Before we start, I'll make an announcement that you should turn your cell phones off or down, because cell phones are pretty new, so it's probably a new thing to you today. Hey, I just got it, so I'm gonna turn this down, so do that. But, if you want, or not.
But feel free to take a picture when I look really cool.
So just turn your cell phone off.
Oh, and one more thing. You can still buy tickets to Beauty and the Beast here at the Playhouse. And they just announced their next season.
Yeah! And Leading Ladies!
Oh, yes, and Leading Ladies. Oh, that has guys dressed up like ladies.
Spoiler alert!
We also have t-shirts for sale. I just thought I'd throw it out there.
Yeah, okay.
We got a lot of them.
We have a lot of those shirts.
All right, on to the game. Do you have the McKenzie file?
Why would you be under the impression that I have any files?
Where did I put my stapler?
Wait, why do we need a stapler?
Have you ever done this job before?
Where else have I been for the last 20 years?
Bob, do you have that McKenzie report?
Why are you paging Bob? What does Bob have to do with this?
Have you seen Bob?
Do you know Bob?
Nope.
What do I look like? Bob's brother?
Am I Bob's brother's keeper?
Did you guys need this?
Why?
Didn't she just page for the McKenzie report?
Is that the McKenzie report? What? Who?
Don't I have another meeting right now?
Where do we get these guys? Jeff?
What happened to the last page?
What do you mean?
Do you see a last page?
Where am I looking?
Where's the file on the table?
What part of the file would you like me to focus on?
What part of the last page didn't you hear?
Why are you always yelling at me? I'm trying my best.
What are we gonna do about this? What are we gonna do? Why are you like this? Who's to say? Do you think I put this dress on every day? Because I want to be treated like that from you?
Why not?
What happened to the last page? Hello? Hello? Are the phones down again? Why did we get these IP phones? They don't work. Why don't you try it?
Why don't I?
Hello? Hello? Is there anyone that... What if this McKenzie file is the only thing that's going to save this branch?
Why deal in what ifs? Why did we get these standing desks? Why do we bother
trying to
make sure people get towed home. Why do any of it? What's the point? Why go on living?
Why do you always get so existential at this point after lunch?
When's my smoke break?
When isn't your smoke break?
How dare you? How dare you?
Do you think just because you're that tall, strapping buck of a man that you're just gonna let me take the heat for this?
Can we change the subject?
I suppose you want to talk about our relationship.
When was the last time we went on a date?
What month is Valentine's Day in?
Would you like to see the new Beauty and the Beast movie?
Wouldn't you rather go see the play?
An animal. Any kind of an animal?
Giraffe.
Giraffe. I heard giraffe. Did it have its baby yet? Is it still punking us? All right. Giraffe, and then a color. Favorite color?
Turquoise.
Turquoise? Okay, this game here, Marv and I are going to review a movie called The Turquoise Giraffe.
Who's starting it, Amant?
These guys are going to act it up. We'll find out, yeah.
Oh, let's have a seat. We've been doing comedy for 5 whole minutes.
Yep. Hi there, and welcome to 2 guys sitting in chairs reviewing a movie. This is what YouTube has brought us. Anyway, let's take a look at that new independent film. It's called, Turquoise Giraffe. I love this so much. Emma Watson is incredible in it. Fresh off her turn as Belle, now she is just, it's a tour de force.
Yeah.
You know, it's amazing. I've loved her since Hermione, but now she is a grown woman.
That's a very interesting thing that you would notice. A little basic, but sure. So she, I thought it was a little miscast, actually, because I didn't sense a lot of chemistry between her and Mr. T.
Oh! But you know what? This is what independent film is about. It's about bringing back stars whose careers had completely died.
Tarantino did it with Travolta.
Right. And now, McGee has done it with Mr. T.
Yeah, director of Charlie's Angels, Full Throttle.
Yeah. So let's just, so in this scene, this is when Emma Watson's character, who is a South African naturalist, meets Mr. T, a tough-as-nails guide, who's going to help her find the turquoise giraffe.
Oh, let's take a look.
Yeah. Are you my guide? Will you take me to the turquoise giraffe?
I pity the fool! Who would say no to a pretty little filly like you? Let's go! I know the way! I know a shortcut! Because I don't do drugs, and I work out!
After you, kind sir.
Follow me! You know what? I'll carry you!
between these two is incredible.
Right, you could feel the heat off the screen.
Yes, yes, it was amazing. But when Michael Fassbender comes in,
oh boy,
as the poacher,
yep,
who ties them up because he's trying to get to the turquoise giraffe
right
before them.
I mean, it's a real race against the clock to see who's going to get to that turquoise giraffe. A color, giraffes just don't normally.
No. But, oh, Michael Fassbender is just amazing as the Chechen poacher.
Right? And what I found more impressive was how he did it with all that green screen so he had no legs.
Yep.
Hey, you two better look at me while I'm talking to you. I know you may find it hard since I've restricted you with those tongs. Yes, I'm calling them tongs because the vocabulary down here hasn't changed since 1832. They're leather tongs.
What do you want with us?
All I have to do is flex my muscles, and we'll be out of this mess. You can flex.
Oh,
flex it.
But you won't, Mr. T. That's the beauty of my plan. I've coiled you together so that I can leap ahead of you and reach the turquoise giraffe before you, which I intend to execute it immediately.
Hold on just a second.
Yeah, yeah.
Have you seen this scene in the overdub of French?
It's a little sexier.
It is so much sexier than French. Let's go back to that.
Yep, we're gonna wind it right back.
Obviously, when we said we're gonna wind it right back, yeah.
Yep. Continuing in French.
Yes, no shoes that see my lack of the tail. God, this is sweet jetan. If I could leap from your beard to the less giraffes at le tout au ciel, cabriolet. Thou kept nepotique.
Ah, but I have been. Let's actually just do this in double time until we get to the escape. Here we go, in double time, there we go.
Yeah, the Boris Kadid. And see my dog. Squeeze, squeeze.
Pick it, your food.
Time as Mr. T blows through those leather tongs.
He's gonna blow right through them.
Pull right, escape out. In half speed. Talked about before.
Where they find the turquoise giraffe.
Right. And why? I guess because she had just done a musical, they figured to make this a musical, I guess.
But not just any song.
No.
No.
No, not just any song.
It for sure was Owner of a Lonely Heart by Yes. If memory serves.
Yeah, I think it was.
I think it was. Yeah.
Yes, we found the turquoise giraffe! Owner of a lonely giraffe!
Tom Hiddleston as the giraffe was a delight.
It's so lifelike!
It looks like it needs special needs.
I think he's just hungry. You know what? Maybe you could soothe it with your
Really? Yeah, that's so much. So much better.
For me.
You know what? I think we have time for just one more thing.
I think we can fit in, maybe. I mean, we really try not to give away spoilers, but since we're not on a network or anything,
right?
We're just sitting in your garage.
Yep.
Yeah, let's spoil the ending, huh?
Yeah, I love when Emma Watson and Mr. T ride off into the sunset on the back of that turquoise garage. Matt and Cullen drove all the way from 192nd and Harrison, which is very far away. Yeah. 6135! And you know, most of those people never, never go any east from 114th.
Yeah, it's scary. It's scary. I'm not scary being down this far.
Yeah. Thank you guys for coming.
Yeah.
We appreciate it.
Yes,
let's do this. We need something that, what's a trivial thing that you find yourself arguing about with a spouse or a...
Laundry.
Laundry? All right. Specifically, what about laundry?
The piles everywhere.
Rotate.
Whose turn it is to do that? Is that putting it away, laundry in general?
Piles, laundry.
Yeah, you want to do laundry? We'll figure it out. All rise! The court of the Weisenheimers is in session. The Honorable Theresa Sindelar, the Poseidon.
Order in the court. I have read your cases. And we are going to start hearing your witnesses and your testimony. We will start with the plaintiff. The plaintiff and the defendant, please. Let's hear from the plaintiff first.
Well, Your Honor, if it pleases the exceptionally large jury, I would like to state the case that in the contemporary American home, it is traditionally the role of the wife to do laundry. A controversial position, I know, and yet here I am making it. The manufacturers of the more popular brands of washing and drying machines, your Maytags, your Kenmores, they made those specifically sized for lady-sized hands and lady-sized...
Objection, Your Honor. Marv seems more like he's from the Trump administration than in real life.
To talk then, I guess?
Oh, wait. Oh. The object, yes.
Sustained.
Yeah, oh, thank you. Now, if you had read our substantial briefs on this, you would have seen that it is our belief and opinion that laundry should be shared equally, 50-50, between the person who can do the laundry and not the person who can't do the laundry. You see, tags are very hard to read, which is why everything goes into one load, and if you have a problem with it, you can kiss my butt.
Objection, objection, Your Honor. This is preposterous advice from a preposterous counsel who clearly is exhibiting a lack of laundry doing for what I gather from his current state of affairs and dress to be the last 15 years.
I agree. Sustain.
I would strongly urge this jury, and y'all have been voir dire, and I won't hesitate to do it again. I will put you into sequestration faster than Matlock on a Thursday afternoon in 1987. I can promise you that. Do not listen to this devilish counsel from the mouth of a hellspawn. My esteemed colleagues from Pitter, Pitter, Patter, and No Bleach. While they may be in earnest, know not one whit about what it takes to successfully do one load of laundry, and I herefore submit to you that anything that comes out of their mouth from this point forward must summarily be discounted. Otherwise, you will perjure yourselves, and I will bind you with...
Yes, Your Honor! This man is clearly using double talk to confuse these lovely people.
Yes, sir.
I mean, sure, you may have space boots on and use fancy words, but we can clearly see by his haircut this man is not from the future, but from the 1950s. I ask you again, kind people, what year are we living in? Is it not the year of our Lord 2016? Or 17? Or 18?
Objection, Your Honor! I know he's my co-counsel, but for the love of God, it is April.
I got worked up! I got a point to make. We should share the load.
Objection, Your Honor. First of all, where he was going with it, but second of all,
I don't believe that these nice people want to see us lectured on what decade we come from a man who looks like he clearly erupted from the 1860s. This is not Silver Dollar City, no.
Go back to your forest, lumberjack!
Thank you.
Sustain!
Objection, Your Honor! I am the only one not doing country lawyer voice. So I should get to talk.
It is sweet as molasses, isn't it? It sure is. Why, it just wins you over with my country charm. A man like this certainly wouldn't lie to you. No, no, not about a lady doing laundry. No, not about a man who would not share his duties in the home. Who cares? I don't know. What are we talking about? Who cares? Listen, folks, I think what's really important...
Objection! Marv's shirt looks like a tablecloth.
Overruled, have you looked at your...
Look at that.
Continue rotarying for Wilco.
I object, Your Honor. Surely we cannot take these points from a man that has elastic at the bottom of his pants and it looks like he's got a load in the drawers. Saying share the load every other day of the week. We, as long as we fold the t-shirts the right way so your insignia over your left breast is showing out, so when I pull out the drawer, I can see what t-shirt it is.
Objection, Your Honor. I do not believe that there can currently be scientifically proven a right way to fold a shirt, but I can scientifically prove, because I tasted Cullen's beard in the last improv game, that this man should not be allowed to petition the bench.
Sustained, I still taste it.
Yes.
I object, Your Honor. What does J. Crew model over here know about laundry at all?
Everything he wears is exactly. Old Navy is owned by the same company as J. Crew. This man has just perjured himself in a court of law, ladies and gentlemen.
Theresa and Marv did such a good job setting women back 50 years. We're gonna send them out of the room, so everyone say goodbye, Theresa and Marv.
That, by the way, was called Objections, a game we haven't done like since 2005. It's exciting.
What you guys don't know about,
should use those chairs or these chairs? Let's use these chairs.
What we what you don't know about Marv and Theresa is they get pulled over by the police a lot, right? Let me just ask you, if you were to see, when you look at me, do you think, am I a good cop or a bad cop?
Bad
cop? All right, so I'll be the bad cop. That would make Matt here the good cop.
Okay.
Matt is a different type of cop besides that. He's got some sort of quirky behavior, odd physical problem. What other type of cop is
disco.
He? What's that?
Disco.
Disco cop.
From the balcony.
From the balcony.
Thanks a lot up there.
Disco cop, okay. All right. Disco. And then I also have something odd about my behavior or physical problems or
correct.
What's that?
Oh, Tourette's cop.
Tourette's? Yes, Duke, were you not here for the beginning?
He's my pregnant wife.
What's that?
He's my pregnant wife.
Pregnant wife cop.
Okay.
Wait, hold on, does that mean that your wife is pregnant, Cody? Because that's my nephew.
Surprise.
Yeah, it's April Fool's, I'm not buying it. Call me tomorrow. This is not when you make announcements, Cody.
This is not your thing!
Yeah!
Well, let me guess, you got engaged at another wedding.
All right, let's rein this in. Right now, Theresa and Marv are seeing all of Act One of Rock of Ages. Matt has another odd behavior or weirdness about him. What other type of cop is he? Lisp. Lisp cop?
Lisping cop.
Lisp, which I think is with an L and a Y, right?
Right, right. Very
He's a lisping cop. And then I have another problem with me. What's with me?
Narcolepsy.
What was that?
Narcolepsy.
Okay.
I think I probably heard drunk, but narcolepsy is so much harder to spell and fit on that card. Narcolepsy. Matt has one more type of thing than he is. What other?
Loves Gloria Estefan.
Loves Gloria Estefan.
The balcony is killing it! What's up, Laura Gould?
Loves Gloria
Estefan. But not
Estefan.
The Miami Sound Machine, right? Screw the Miami Sound Machine. Loves Gloria Estefan. Okay. And finally, I have one more type of cop. I'm one more type of cop. What am I?
Tiny hands.
I prefer the term dainty.
Or right-sized.
Yes. They're average-sized hands. What are you talking about? They're totally average.
Said so on the internet.
Yeah, I've read it. I told my doctor, and he said it's fine. All right, so what's going to happen is we're going to get Marv and Theresa back here, and they're going to be pulled over by these cops. We're going to hold up these signs so you remember what we are. Matt and I are going to be each one of these types of cops in succession. Now, when they guess what we are, give them a big clap, right? If they're almost there, you can give them a golf clap to help them out a little bit, let them know they're on the right track. But big clap when they've done it, and when that happens, we will switch to the next type of cop. Does that make sense?
Yeah, I got it.
You got it?
Yep.
Do you want to go get him?
Oh, yeah.
All right. So, Oh, and when you read this, try not to vocalize it, which gives away the whole game.
my mom's birthday tomorrow.
Really?
Yeah, she's here tonight.
I love you, Bonnie.
Oh, happy New Year!
And if you believe that crap, she's gonna be a great grandma, so who knows? Oh, there she is.
Alright.
Yeah.
You ready?
I'm ready. Let's
All
go.
Right, let's okay. get this.
I'm so glad we bought this driving instructor car. Just my fake brake and extra wheel over here. I'm gonna let you take it.
Okay, bye.
Honey, what were you doing? Half a block.
You should have drove.
Oh, the waiting is the hardest part. Tom Petty was right.
Hi. Oh, hi. Hi. Excuse me. Yeah, could you roll it?
Yep.
Let's roll it. Oh, it's automatic.
It's
an automatic.
It's automatic. It's that. This is, yeah.
I'm from the 50s.
Oh.
Hey. Don't want to harsh your day. Just wanted to pull you guys over gently to the side of the road and let you know that you were proceeding a little hastily through that school zone back there.
I've got an actual lead foot. It's actually...
Do
it's,
you
it's
know?
A hot yeah. It's actually a hot foot. Yeah.
Make a move! Make a move! I mean, it is made of lead. I'm gonna. So...
Guys, before you get too freaked out, I know Ted, we work in the same precinct. He is violent, but deep inside, he's a very sweet man. We're in a book club together. Don't judge him. Don't judge him on his.
I'm a patriot!
That's real random, but okay.
Listen,
you guys go down.
I'm not even give you a citation.
It's fine, honey. I'll do the talking,
okay.
Obviously.
I'm warming up to you.
Clearly, I am from the 50s as well.
It's like at home. I can't get a word in.
The men are speaking. Listen. I'm making so many good choices tonight. Listen, you don't have to play good cop, bad cop with us. We get it. That was a close one. I have got a lot of weed in here. That was a bad day for me to move a whole brick, huh? Okay. Let's go. Yes. Back up on the road. Let's get all the way. We're never gonna get to Brentwood Square at this speed. Yes, officer?
Are you guys gonna go anywhere near like a McDonald's or?
I mean, this is America, so probably.
I know I shouldn't, but can you give me a strawberry shake? And don't tell me what Dr. Patel said. I got it, I know. All right, my sugar is fine. You with a police escort.
Yeah.
I can provide you with a
Once I catch my breath, yeah, actually, I would appreciate it. Sure. Listen,
you know what? Your mother has been bothering me all day.
I apologize for that. I certainly hope the puddle underneath of you is because it's raining. I can't believe they would make you continue in regular duty as a pregnant cop.
Yes, that's true. But it's specifically our relationship.
You're my pregnant wife cop?
Yes.
Okay.
We should talk about that.
Honey, the men are talking, okay? We'll get back to that.
I know you guys are really amped up to go to Funky Town, but wouldn't it be more fun if you guys just turned on your high beams and clicked them as I shook my groove thing in front of your grill? Like, just a little.
Yeah, it'd be like a big disco party. It'd be like, you know.
Yeah. Like a disco dance.
Yeah. Hey, drive safe, guys.
Hey, guys, I'm sorry. I would love to let you get going. I just need your license and
This is like a cop clown car. yeah.
Station. I just need your license and registration, proof of insurance, that sort of thing.
Sure.
Hey, sir. Please. What are you reaching for there?
Well, my license and register.
Okay, just make it kind of easy, all right? I don't want to get all excited, intense about it, okay? I don't like getting excited. Just go ahead. All right,
who does?
Nice and easy.
Are the Pointer Sisters.
They do get so excited. Yeah. There's that. I don't know why I keep all of that in there like that, but...
Wow, you grew up in the that's the street I grew up on. That street right there, Birchwood Avenue. Look at
Birchwood
that.
Birchwood Avenue, yeah.
That's amazing.
Birchwood.
Hey, you! Shut up! We're trying to do police.
This is this is a complex one, huh?
Business, police business. All right. Shut up.
Sorry. Just kind of a function of the job. I want to stop you guys right there.
Uh-huh.
I want to stop you.
Okay.
Everybody
this is
listening?
This is my partner, Officer Stevenson.
Everybody listening. Because what I'm going to say is extremely of high importance.
Yeah. My doctor said taking a shower wakes you up, which is why they partnered me with him.
Got it. Yeah.
Well, you can...
I spent 12 years undercover trying to break up a drug ring.
Yeah. Oh, that'd be...
But then they transferred me out of that division.
Sure.
Yeah.
Yep.
Keep on going, Wise Cat. See what happens.
That'd be funny, though. Like, you know... Narc.
But I feel like I feel like maybe not solely a narcoleptic.
No, it's just tension makes you go.
Okay. This is
can I just be honest and vulnerable with you guys?
a little bit of that got in my mouth.
I'm sorry. I am out here doing my best, trying to protect and serve.
You have a list!
I know. No, hey, I understand. I probably have hepatitis OPD now.
I'm sorry. You only gave me your driver's license. I also need to see your proof of insurance and registration, please.
Okay.
Okay? Please don't make me pull out this Dillinger.
Pull out what?
You know this Dillinger? It's my police issued Dillinger. Best traffic stop. Anyway, that's what people are saying. Spoiler alert,
I'm not even sure that has anything to do with you. You have to guess. But can I get your, just give me your proof of insurance there?
I mean, I don't.
He's a white male. Does that help?
Come on,
anything?
Right?
Like he's
why you didn't get shot by the first one?
No.
Oh. Come on. Come on. Hey, I want to tell you, hey, listen, hey, you get a two-cop stop 5 miles from a school, boy, that's a comedy, huh? But listen, here's what it's going to be, okay? As you can tell, closely related to the first cop I did, right? Okay, but with a little difference, okay, because I got a little Cuban, okay? And I love a horn section. So you get the rhythm bumping, you see my neighbor, boy, that's when the baby occurred. You know what I mean?
It's really also closely related apparently to my previous job as well. Hey, let me just give this back. It looks so giant when I hold it, right? Here, let me get my little castanets.
Oh, look at this. Look at this, my castanets are coming out. You know what I mean? Police uniform or something, it'll fit. So you know what I do, right?
I think we should wait for our lawyer to arrive.
But you gotta make do. So, hey, you know what I love even more than the thing I love?
What's that?
I love the thing I love more than this, but when it start out with like a sound, then you put it to a machine, but then you take the primary sound out of the machine, give it a solo career, circa 1987,
sure.
And then you got it. You really got something. I'm sorry you have to see my nipple.
I'm sorry about it.
You know, I'm sorry that the rhythm got you.
The rhythm got me. Yeah, you got it. You got it.
I have to get back to my golfing, apparently, with my not-average-sized club,
of course.
If you got what I'm saying.
We've known for a while, Trump cop.
It's just specifically
tiny hand cop. You picked a lot of it.
Yeah.
Obviously.
Yeah, I love Gloria Estefan.
Our next game, I pulled something.
Yep.
That was.
What were you pulling back there in the dark?
You put your jacket on.
I'm good.
They're gonna get more. You're gonna get warmer.
I want to create a sheen to share when the people
do that.
Now that most of us are sweaty, what we need right now is a member of the audience to help us out.
Do we have a volunteer?
Who would be willing to help us out?
Oh, right here?
Yeah.
Here, ladies and gentlemen.
Yes.
All right. So, have you ever acted before? Well, you won't have to very
maybe.
Much.
Maybe a little bit.
So, here's what's going to happen. They're all real, sir. It's okay. So first and foremost, what's a stressful situation you find people in?
Bank robbery.
All right. So you're going to be helping Teresa out. You're going to be in a scene about a bank robbery, but you are not going to speak any English whatsoever. You are going to speak a language that you. I know you already know this language. It kind of sounds like gibberish, just random syllables to everyone else, but you know it, and Marv over here is fluent in it. So what we're going to do is, you're going to act out this scene with Teresa, a bank robbery is somehow occurring, you'll speak in that lovely gibberish language, and then Marv will translate for us. Okay? Can you handle that?
And what is your name?
Oh,
perfectly.
And what was your name again, Peter?
You can say that in English.
It's a good thing, Papa.
Oh, right.
Brenda.
Brenda. All right. So here it is. They're going to act out a scene, a bank robbery. Marv's going to translate. I have to ask this because Theresa requires it in her contract. You're not drunk now and will sober up during this game, right? Okay. Because that's happening. All right.
Bank robbery.
Okay, Brenda, we should really get everything ready. This is your... Are you sensing something? I know you're a psychic, Brenda.
Oh, tickle, tickle, bo.
I feel like someone's going to die today.
Someone's going to die today, Brenda? What's your spirit animal? Coyote. So this scene is going to be about a coyote, and I want to see what you can give me in 2 minutes, okay? I'm going to stand over here so I can time you. So whenever you're ready, I'm going to time you. I'm going to see what you can create in 2 minutes.
I think this is where we're supposed to meet the coyote. He's going to get us across the border back into Mexico.
It's been so hard to sneak into Mexico since the wall got built.
I know.
This seems like
hey,
a really...
Hey, muchachos! That's are you guys trying to sneak into Guadalajara?
We are trying to sneak into Walla-la-la-la.
Hey, back off, man! This is my Camaro.
It's a little on the nose, but okay.
Weird, it looked like a bar.
That's why I call this the Coyote Ugly.
Please keep your top on.
I won't want to scare you with all of my scars.
Not me? Yeah, no mean.
We? Are we going to do this or not?
Are you Enrique?
Are you Jeff?
Maybe.
Then maybe I am Enrique.
No, I mean, there's a lot of Jeffs in the world.
No, but probably not in this bar,
oh,
man.
Yeah.
Like, you look like...
Well,
the
I just want to be specific.
I know, but you look
Gail,
like
I want to be specific.
You look
now,
like
hold on a second. He's Gail? I thought you were bringing Oprah's friend.
Different Gales.
No, there's a lot of Gales in
there's a lot of Jeffs.
There's a lot of Jeffs. There's a lot of Gales.
I thought he was going to be Jeff Bridges.
This is just my buddy Gale. Yes,
now.
You know? He's named after the...
Do you want to go across the border or not?
Yes.
Yeah.
Get in the car.
In the Camaro? To touch?
You... Well, you just don't go through the country. I just didn't want you to climb on top of the Camaro. Get in the Camaro.
I had a Camaro in high school, and I know that it's tight in the back seat. So, we're you want us both to fit back there.
I mean, one of you can ride up front.
Shotgun!
Time? Okay.
Yes.
Nope, don't stop it. That was horrible.
Stop there!
Stop it!
Don't
quit pandering!
Don't encourage that. Because, there were some moments, but I think they could, if they tightened it up a little bit, I think it would be better. So I want to see the exact same scene, but in a minute. You know, I want you to cut out the fat bit. You know, I want you to cut out the air.
Right. Yeah, that's it. Right.
How did this scene start?
Are the leaf refits.
Ready?
1 minute. I want to see that 1 minute.
I think this is where we're supposed to meet the coyote to get us across the border over into Mexico.
Oh, it's been so hard to get into Mexico since they built that wall.
Are you guys telling to get over there and across the wall?
We
in the border, huh?
We are trying to get to Guadalajara.
Now I will take you. Don't go through my Camaro.
Are you Enrique?
Are you Jeff?
Well, there's a lot of Jeffs in the world. So it
I mean, but dude, you
what's
do,
the
I
last
mean, there's,
name?
There's not a lot of Jeffs.
Gail! Quiet! Wait a minute. This is Gail. I thought it was going to be Oprah's face.
There's a lot of Gales. There's a lot of Jeffs. There's a whole bunch of shit in the world. We just need to get into Mexico.
Well, let's say there is only one Enrique. Get into my Camaro.
Whoa, the back seat?
One of you can ride up front.
Shotgun!
No Rochambeau?
Get in, let's go!
Alright, yeah, okay, that was 45 seconds.
Wow,
really?
We could probably do it even quicker though. Because
those were the only lines that I could remember.
You know what? Okay, that was 45 seconds, and let's do it in half of that time, so let's...
22
let's,
seconds?
Let's do it in 22 seconds. You know, I think this. I think okay. We're onto something. You know, like, that was much
22
better.
Seconds.
22 seconds. Let's do that in 22 seconds.
I think this is where we're supposed to meet the coyote.
Are you guys going to try to get off the road?
There's a wall!
Guadalajara, the wall.
Enrique?
Enrique?
A lot of Jeffs.
Gail!
Oprah!
No, there's a lot of Jeffs, a lot of Gales.
Jeff, you want a Camaro?
In the back seat?
Rochambeau!
Extended. I've done. I've been faster.
So let's see it in seven.
Really speaks a lot about us that we're not even using all the time.
No, yeah.
We're consummate performers.
7 seconds.
Hey, is this the wolf Enrique?
Big Guadalajara.
Guadalajara.
My Camaro.
Gail.
Well, Jeff Bridges.
Opera. Shotgun.
Four.
Yep.
Yes.
Four.
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 Monty,
spit on five.
I see four.
Monty, you're not really playing with house money at this point.
I raise you to three. Do it in 3 seconds.
3 seconds.
Got it.
All right.
Ready?
Go.
And we get the ball.
Give it. I still felt that was not right.
Nope, I can do it better.
One second.
Let's do this.
I feel like it takes me more than 1 second to walk.
Ready? Go.
Come on.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, that is my phone. Thank you.
Is that how it is? It's nice to take a break from the laughter, huh?
Yeah.
Let's settle for a second.
You guys tired too?
We're almost to intermission, but we wanted to really class this up with the poem.
The classiest type of poem there is.
Yeah.
A limerick.
Because there's five of us.
So we like a subject you've never heard a poem or a limerick about.
Paleontology.
I heard Scientology.
Is that what it was?
Okay.
Paleontology.
Oh, good. Thank God, because I would like to act in Hollywood. Yeah. So I was like, how are we going to bail out of this one?
We are recording the show, so we don't want it to.
It's kind of a demo type situation.
They've already filed litigation.
So paleontology.
So here is a limerick about paleontology.
Paleontology. All right. There once was a dinosaur named Dave. The asteroids came and his friends he could not save.
One day he said, "Hey!
It won't be okay
if I take this ankylosaurus jawbone and act totally depraved."
Rotate.
Okay, we're doing another one?
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right.
That was quick.
Okay.
What would we like another limerick about? Yeah.
Sasquatch.
I heard outhouses first.
Outhouses. Yes.
You want to throw a Sasquatch in?
Yeah. Where Sasquatch ends up in that outhouse.
Double play. I like
Let's
it.
Let's do it.
I discovered a Sasquatch in the outhouse.
A revealing blouse. I couldn't help but to peek.
And then I went around and sneaked.
And saw that scummy lot mouse.
Weird. That was a weird one.
I'm tired of rhyming.
Let's keep doing it. We're getting back.
One more subject, and I think this will be funny.
Garbage trucks?
Sure. There's a theme that's beginning.
My ride, some would say, is quite stinky.
The contents are gray, brown, and pinky.
When I ride on the back, I pick up the sack.
And I give all the ladies a winky.
Friends.
Yeah.
Jordan. What's your name?
Jordan.
Give it up for Jordan.
What's your last name?
Jordan Hauserman.
Jordan Hauserman.
Gonna do it on the offbeat then, huh?
Yes.
Jordan Hauserman is.
Jordan.
This is a song we wrote a long time ago about Jordan Hauserman.
Yep.
And we'd like to share it with you guys right now.
Came out in 1984. It's on our greatest hits package.
One more time around.
I should be the one that starts.
Jordan Hauserman is
hoping that beard comes in.
Jordan Hauserman is
mighty tiny.
Jordan Hauserman is
no idea what he's in store for.
Jordan Hauserman is
fixing to put my eye out with his cowlick.
Jordan Hauserman is
working a look that says, yes, 1996.
Jordan Hauserman is
kind of sad he stood up first.
Jordan Hauserman is
unable to even afford Toms.
Jordan Hauserman is
not only a client, but the president.
Jordan Hauserman is
contemplating murdering every last one of us before we get to the car.
Jordan Hauserman is
stuffing.
Jordan Hauserman, you're my best friend. What a guy.
Jordan Hauserman.
What? Jordan Hauserman is
really regretting coming to his first Weisenheimer show.
Jordan Hauserman is
this close to being beat in the UFC.
Jordan Hauserman is
really used to being left swiped.
Smells like sandalwood.
Jordan Hauserman is
mixed with orange Monster energy drink.
Jordan Hauserman is
a grower, not a shower.
Jordan Hauserman is
just too short to ride the ride.
Jordan Hauserman is
a really good sport.
Jordan Hauserman is
double stuffing.
Jordan Hauserman, you're my best friend, and I'll be with you to the end. Jordan Hauserman, a hell of a guy. Jordan Hauserman, why? Jordan Hauserman.
Take 10 minutes to get drinks. The bar will be closed after intermission, so
shoot up.